Hello, welcome to IQ Pop. In this video, I'll show you the air diagram in short. So, in air diagram, we represent relation between entity and relation between entities in pictorially, right? So, how we represent entity in the air diagram? We represent entity in square rectangular boxes, right? Say student as entity, so student entity should be in rectangular box in air diagram. Next is, if there is an entity, that entity is going to have some attributes. So for student, the attributes may be name. It may be roll number, it may be phone number, it may be date of birth, right? Now there is different kind of attributes. As you know, first is composite attribute. So composite attribute is attribute which have multiple values, multiple attribute. You can say it is built up with multiple attributes. So name can be built up with first name and second name. So it is a composite attribute. Next is multi-valued attribute. So you can say phone number, you can say this is a multi-valued attribute because it is having multiple values. One value is say STD code, another value is say the phone number. Next is so multi-valued attribute we represent by double LFs. Okay. Next is derived attribute. So we have date of birth. Now from date of birth we can calculate another attribute called age. So derived attributes we keep in dashed LFs. So these are the notations about entities and attributes. Next is another thing is there, that is relationship. So relationships are given by diamond shaped box. Okay, so say we have two entities here, entity O, one entity here, another entity, and the relation between them are going to be represented by diamond shaped box. So here if one-to-one relationship is there between the student, this entity, say this is entity 1 and entity 2, then we are going to give them 1-1 in both sides. But if there is one to many relationship, then we give like this. This is entity 1, this is entity 2. Okay, so it may be like as a student, it may be course. So one student may have n number of courses, right? So you can say enroll relationship. Another thing can be there, that is many to one relationship, like student related with a school. So there may be n number of students in one school. Okay, so In the same way, there may be many to many relationship. Say entity 1 and entity 2, and their multiple entity are related with multiple entity 2, and multiple entity 2 are related with multiple entity 1. So we represent it like this. Next, total participation and partial participation. So as I have told you previously, that there is a relation between faculty and department. So right, say one faculty manages one department, but in the department there is n number of faculties, any number of faculties may be there, but there is nothing like that every faculty are going to go manage the department. We need one faculty only to manage the department. So here one to one relationship is there, but this part is true for only one faculty, right? So it is going to be a partial participation. Now, if you look at this side, one department must be managed by some faculty. So there is no doubt. So it is going to be a total participation. So total participation is shown by double line. Now, as we had taken in our previous discussion, university database as a case study. So if we do that one in short, I am not showing the attributes, only entities I am showing you due to shortage of time. So student was one entity. So there may be program which can be another entity. So you can say that student enroll for a program. That is true, right? Now question is that there is n number of student can enroll for a single program. So the relationship between student and program is many to one. So now one program can have some courses. Now here you can see these courses are not going to exist if there is no program going to be exist. So this is a weak entity. So weak entity we keep in double lined rectangle. In the same way, this relation is going to be a weak relationship. So this is also going to be a double lined diamond shape. So it is again one program can have n number of courses. So you can say contain. Okay, the next there may be the course can be managed by some faculty. So now one faculty can manage n number of courses. One faculty can teach n number of courses, right? So all right. So there may be another attribute. that is called school, not attribute, that is another entity, right? So unschool offers some program, faculty manages some school, so one faculty can manage only one school, one school can offer n number of programs, so like this. Right, so I have not shown the attributes, so there is attributes are there, so attributes you can identify and you can add them, any numbers of attribute may be there, so there may be some attributes with this relationship also, say this program contains course and it may be in which year, it may be semester. Okay, so these things may be there. So this is a little bit about air diagram. Thank you for watching.